I'm Naomi Sheldon, a writer and performer of Good Girl. It's a relief. it's been a long journey that the show's been on. I'm starting off in Edinburgh. It's my debut piece, my debut play. So coming to this lovely space with an amazing audience, so responsive, has been a really beautiful part of the journey. I'm very, very pleased and very lucky. It was around about this time last year that I really fully started writing the play. So it's a year ago. I'd been up to Edinburgh and seen lots of solo shows, and I just felt like it was time for me to write something, that I had a story in me. And I was seeing all these brilliant women writing, and I thought, yes, yeah, it's time for me to add my voice to that. I wasn't getting any really interesting roles. I mean, it's the same old story, isn't it? And I thought, bugger it. I thought I'll write myself a good one, and then actually that went away. It became all about the story. And once I started writing, I could not stop. I started off just putting thoughts down, this story coming out of me based on growing up in the 90s in Sheffield. And when I read it back to my director, Matt Peaver, it was awful. It was awful. it was like an essay. And then we tried a different tack, because I'm a storyteller, I'm an actor. So we started improvising, hour-long improvisations, like just do a show for an hour. And that's when it came alive, because I suddenly realised that I had a story in me to tell, and I wanted to connect with people on a storytelling level. And that's how this sort of one-woman show came about, really. So it's partly autobiographical, the story. I think like a lot of people's shows are. Like, I'd say it's honest rather than factual. Like, a lot of my old school friends came to see it and they didn't recognise themselves in it. So, I mean, they're not real people, I guess, or inspired by. It's really about a character called Gigi, Good Girl, who grows up in the 90s in Sheffield. And she's a very big feeling woman. She feels a lot, and she feels ashamed about those feelings because she's been taught to. And it's about how eventually she learns to cut off her feelings in order to feel good, like a good girl. And what hellish life that leads to, this sort of numbness of not being able to trust your gut feeling, of not being able to trust yourself, about being fed images about what kind of a woman you should be, and not really having any sense of an instinct anymore as to what kind of woman you want to be. So it's about that, and goes right up into the present day. And I hope it's not spoon-feeding any philosophy or, any solution to the problem that so many of us women find ourselves in, of sort of having internalised this patriarchal idea of being a good girl. But I hope that by the end, I suppose, people have connected with the concepts and the ideas and seen themselves reflected back on them on the stage, both men and women. It's for both. It's for all people, really. People who are told that they're only allowed to feel a certain thing. Like, men are only allowed to feel angry, not sad. Women are only allowed to cry, not feel rage. So I hope that it's just opening up those conversations and that we can start progressing. I feel like the comedy is essential. It's funny, in some audiences, if they haven't laughed very much at the beginning, it's been much harder to deliver the sadder, the more hard-hitting stuff at the end. Somehow, comedy and tragedy live hand in hand, and it's so essential to be able to see lightness through things that aren't necessarily intrinsically comic, and then explore the sad stuff. Then you sort of earned it, I feel. For me, anyway, that's my taste. So the music in the show is really important to me. And as I say at the end of the show, and it's true for me, this is autobiographical, is that I can tell how terrible I've been feeling by how much ABBA it takes me to feel back to normal again. It's true. Like, that is my, it's like my medicine. Music is my medicine, I guess, in many ways. So the Madonna and the ABBA and the Michael Jackson, stuff that I used to listen to growing up, stuff that used to make me feel wild and free, it's really important for me that it punctuates the show. It's kind of like a building up of what's to come of that final section about music. That's really important. But references like that digital bubble watch ring, I mean, I have one of those. Guinea pigs, who hasn't had a guinea pig? which girl hasn't had a guinea pig? What else? Oh, yeah, wearing Body Shop white mask. I mean, I was with that in Dewsbury. I could not stop wearing those scents. Yeah, and also, I suppose, also the fact that the boys are drawing dicks on everything, that's something, or willies on everything, that's something. Like, I went on a holiday last year, it's been a while, and we were in Italy, and we saw, like, this beautiful old monument, and boys had drawn a penis on it. It's like, what? It's everywhere, on everything. What is this totem, this thing that we're worshipping? And it's true, I did start to draw vaginas on stuff when I was a kid, and it was complicated. I feel it's important that women are writing and performing things. I, throughout this process, have had so many times of feeling like, oh, I'm not good enough for this. Who am I to be taking up this space? Really strong feelings that I didn't have I shouldn't be using my voice. I don't know, I mean, where has that come from? I'm meant to be, you know, a liberated, independent woman, and yet still these voices of doubt scream at me all the time, even tonight, you know, who are you to be performing this, telling this story, why you? And why not a man? So I feel it's really important to have our voices, both through the writing and physically, audibly here, to be heard, because it's still terrifying to take up space. It's a palpable fear, and we need to start facing it and blasting through it. Feminist. I wear the name feminist with pride, and I'll fight for it, and back it up always. It's probably the most important label I own. Good Girl is running at Trafalgar Studios 2 until the 31st of March, and you can buy tickets on the ATG website. We're also going to be having panels on emotion every Tuesday evening, emotion and sex, emotion and politics, and emotion and identity that people can attend.